Today, let's talk about Canon's drop-in ND filter for the EOS R. I'm Rafael, and welcome to the channel. So I want to talk about the pros and cons of the drop-in ND filter. Initially, when I bought the EOS R, I wanted to continue using my lenses, so adapter was definitely going to be a necessity. They have the EF lens adapter, or they have this drop-in ND adapter, which I feel for my workflow is definitely more valuable. So that's the ND adapter, and it literally just drops in. So right off the bat, one of the biggest cons, the fact that it leaves this big gaping hole when you pull out the adapter. Now, you don't have to take it out a lot, but there are instances where the light is getting low and you lose one or two stops if you leave this in wide open. So the way around that is you have to take the adapter out. It creates this big gap right beside your sensor. So if you need to get that extra little stop in, it's not the best way, but if you need to get that shot right away, that's fine. Or you can buy a clear filter that you drop in place. It's an extra few dollars that you have to buy. So you have to carry at least one of these clear filters to put in that open hole. As you can see, even fully wide open, it still cuts out light by at least one stop. So there are situations where you'll want it to be fully wide open. If you're using light meter, you'll need to compensate accordingly. I definitely recommend buying the drop-in clear filter because there will be low light situations where you're gonna want as much light getting onto the sensor as possible. So the ND filter works really well. The added benefit is that it's behind the lens. So it actually gives you ND filters behind every single lens that you own. And because it's made by Canon, it works natively with every single sensor. I haven't noticed any issues once I figured out the settings of the camera. It has worked fantastic. The autofocus works. Now it's smooth, so if you need to do a ramp while shooting, that's fine. But you can't really add specific stops. It doesn't really say how many stops it is. It just has a min, mid, and max. So you can't really adjust it accordingly. Overall, I'm really happy with the variable ND filter. I haven't noticed any color shifts. The only downside is that you lose that one stop if it's wide open. In most cases in shooting outdoors, it really helps to open up the aperture all the way. And the lenses and everything work natively with it, so I'm able to use all my glass. Now I have a built-in ND filter for every single one of my lenses. So that's a super bonus that I love. That's one of the reasons why this system, for me, works really, really well, because now I work with this camera the same way I do with the C200. Is the Canon variable ND drop-in filter EF adapter worth it? Short answer, yes. Definitely I would recommend this over the standard EF mount adapter, mainly because you're able to have a ND filter right after the lens and before the sensor. So it starts to feel and work and act like a cine camera, which is fantastic. I highly recommend this if you're really thinking about it. It's worth the extra money just for that feature alone. It allows you to have an ND filter with you for every single lens that you have in your kit. So you don't have to bring every single ND filter. The only other thing I would recommend is make sure you do get the clear filter, because if there are situations in low light or you're indoors, you don't need the ND filter, you can swap it out really quickly. So you just carry this one clear filter to be able to film in lower light situations. It's well thought out. It works really well. Definitely check it out. Make sure it's right for you. If you're thinking about the Canon EOS R, check out this video about choosing the right camera for you. I cover 5 fundamental questions you should ask yourself before buying into a new camera system. And this is definitely a new camera system with this new lens mount and adapters that come along with it. Check out the video where I talk about why the Canon EOS R was the right choice for me as a secondary camera. All right, guys, that's it. Let me know what you think. Give me a big thumbs up, subscribe. I'll talk to you soon. Bye for now.